We're talking about the gift of prophecy, and it's wonderful to know that God wants each one of us as believers to flow in this gift. And the reason for this is that the body of Christ can be benefited, can be blessed. Prophecy brings in edification, exhortation, comfort from the heart of God. And prophecy also releases the purposes of God, the plans of God, and also unearths hidden potential in the hearts of people. Now, there could be certain things that are in my heart, that God-given potential which are there, which are lying dormant, which I may not be aware of, but the prophetic word really unearths that, releases that. And it's such a privilege to know that God has called us and God wants to use us in this. One of the things is that we need to have the right motivation for the gift. For example, if you see 1 Corinthians 14, where Paul talks about this gift, and verse 12, he says, even so you, since you are zealous for spiritual gifts, let it be for the edification of the church that you seek to excel. Which means the motivation for me desiring this gift, the real motive why I want to use this gift should be for the edification of the church. Which means that church is just ecclesia, which means people who are called by God. So when I desire these gifts, when I seek to excel in these gifts, it's to bless people. It's to build up the people of God. It's to build up my fellow Christian, my fellow believer, brother and sister, and nothing else. So let that be the motive. So we must check our motives. Do I want to bless someone? Do I want to encourage someone? Like Paul writes about the church in Philippi, where people preach Christ, but with a selfish ambition, with the motive which was selfish, which was they were preaching him or preaching Christ out of envy and so on. So our motive must be right. We could be doing something as noble as ministering in the gifts, but then our motives must be right. So we need to check our motives. It should not be to just promote ourselves or to look cool, or to say to the world, look how wonderfully I'm being used by God. And it's never to that, or it's never to wear the gift as a label. Here I am, a wonderful prophet of God. It's never that. It's always to bless the church. It's always to edify the church, right? So we check our motive. One way to do is to prepare ourselves. Why do I want to do that? We see that, okay, my motive is not right. And the best response to that is, I'm going to realign my motive. I want to change my heart. I want to have a change of heart. And I'm going to desire the spiritual gift. I want to go after, pursue love and desire spiritual gifts. So that's the thing. And another thing to watch out for is that we separate our heart from our personal or prejudices or our personal experiences. For example, if God has called me for full-time ministry, if I was working in a corporate setting, and if God had called me for for a full-time so-called full-time ministry, then I set aside that personal experience. If there's a prophetic word for a person to be in ministry, then I should not be in a hurry to say, God wants you to leave where you are and come into this full-time ministry or work in the church and so on because of my experience, personal experience. So I should not let that color the prophetic word, right? Let the prophetic word be authentic. Let me set aside my personal experience and then move in the prophetic. So let's pray and ask God that we will prepare our hearts. Our motives will be pure. Our personal experiences will be set aside so that we can deliver the authentic and pure prophetic word. Father, we thank you. We pray that our hearts will be set right, that our motives will be pure, that there will be no impure motives, God. It'll be never to promote ourselves. It'll be never to be in the spotlight or to wear the gift as a label or to show how special we are. But God, we pray that it'll always be to edify the church, to bless the church. And we pray, God, we just humble ourselves under your mighty hand, that you will exalt, you will lift us up, God. We thank you for this time. We give you all praise and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.